To my brothers and sisters in the EPC, grace and peace to you and our Lord Jesus Christ. My name is Dean Weaver, and I'm privileged to serve you as the stated clerk of the EPC. And this is the second of two videos promoting some big important items that are coming to our General Assembly this summer. So if you're a member of the EPC, please be in prayer for us. If you're a commissioner, please listen up, as this is one of the two big items coming by way of recommendation from the national leadership team. Previously, I spoke about recommendation 42-10, which is a pastoral letter of racial lament and hope. Now I'd like to speak to you about recommendation 42-11, which is moving in our funding formula from PMA, or per member asking, to POI, which is percentage of income. So let me drill down on the POI recommendation, if I would, but for a second. First of all, on PMA. PMA is a model of supporting presbyteries and the General Assembly through what's called per member asking. We haven't changed our per member asking really since 2006. So I'd like you to think for a moment about anything you know of that costs the same thing today as it did in 2006, let alone maybe 6 days ago or 6 weeks ago. Well, you can well imagine we've lost quite a bit against inflation over the years, and it's getting exceedingly difficult for us to fund the Office of the General Assembly as we serve our presbyteries and local churches with the existing formula. And you might ask yourself the question, well, what does the Office of the General Assembly look like? Is it becoming a large institution where we're supporting all these new positions? I would say to you, in 2006, when our per member asking was the exact amount that it is today, which is $23 per person, we had 24 staff in the Office of the General Assembly. We only had 187 churches at the time. Today, we have 637 churches plus about 50 church plants, and still $23 per person PMA, and our staff is still 24 people. Exact same number, different people, but the same number. So the Office of the General Assembly is not a large and bloated top-down government bureaucracy. It is a lean, mean church missional machine. And your support, I promise you, we are really good stewards of those resources. In fact, 20% of what you give just off the top goes to World Outreach to support them. And there's lots of other good stuff too. But let me talk about why the switch. The switch is not just because a PMA is an outdated modes of support of the denomination. In fact, some of our presbyteries are already changing away from that. A lot of other denominations have changed away from that. It's actually not a very equitable means of support. Imagine you had a church in the Northeast, in Connecticut, say, with 150 members and a median income of $150,000 per household. Now imagine a church, say, in a rural community like West Virginia that's got 150 members, but their median family income is about $50,000 per household. They're both giving the same amount to the General Assembly. That's probably not quite right. There's a lot of other reasons. Different churches view membership differently and all of those kind of things, but it's time. It's time for us to make that change. And what we're considering doing is recommending that we would move to a percentage of income approach to supporting the General Assembly. Now, what that means is every year in your annual church reports, your church reports back the amount of money that your congregation receives by way of tithes and offerings, regular revenues to the regular operating ministry budget of your church. Not things outside of that, not preschools or not special offerings or other outside budgets, but just the main operating expenses of your church. Those tithes and offerings, as they come in by way of income, that would be, we would base a 1% of that going to the Office of the General Assembly. Now, for some churches, that's going to mean it stays pretty flat. For some, the amount that they would want to give to the denomination might go up, and for some, it would go down. We're hoping over a three-year period of time, the churches that have a slight uptick would maybe try to make some incremental change in that direction if they're able to do so. And the churches that see the downtick, well, they would hopefully maintain while this three-year period of time enables us to develop a new equilibrium in terms of funding of the denomination. our belief and hope is that by not only making this move, but by beginning to engage all of our congregations that are not supporting the larger church financially, that over the next 3 to 5 years, we'll see an income raise of about $500,000, which will go not to support more staff or more infrastructure, but more ministry in the life of the EPC, fully funding our strategic priorities. That is the goal. So that's the move from PMA to POI. We've been sharing about that in our presbyteries this last year. It comes with a full recommendation of our finance team and the national leadership team, and we hope you'll give prayerful consideration about that issue as you come to the 42nd General Assembly. I look forward to seeing you there.